Hello friends, so today we are again going to learn, rather continue the transformational grammar. It's a big idea of transformational grammar where there are so many transformations that we can see when we are using languages. And today we are going to do the simplest kind of transformational grammar. So now we will look at the next transformation that we often see happening with the assertive sentences. If you remember, we did a few videos back about the kinds of sentences, and there were four kinds of sentences. So these are the transformation of those sentences that we are going to look into. See the statement and how the transformation has taken place. She says, I am writing a letter to my brother. She says that she is writing a letter to her brother. Now, this is an assertive sentence. You remember what is an assertive sentence, and you see the change of tense or the change of pronouns. She says, I was not writing a letter to my brother. She says that she was not writing a letter to her brother. She said to me, I am writing a letter to my brother. She told me that she was writing a letter to her brother. It's the same sentence if you see in different forms. And it is an assertive sentence. So how the tense and the pronouns change? In the first one we see that because it is a simple present tense, there is no change in tense, and she says that she is writing a letter is the same as what is there in the direct speech. Second one we see that she says I was not writing a letter. She says she was not writing a letter. Absolutely no change in the sentence of the tense, in the sentence with the tense. But yes, there was change in the pronouns in the first one, second one and third one. And the third one is she said to me, she told me that she was writing a letter. Now this is past tense and therefore the indirect speech becomes past. So to convert such sentences into indirect narration, we have to use the basic rules as we saw in the earlier videos, except that sometimes the said is replaced by told, especially when there is another object with the subject in the reporting speech, where the person who said something to somebody is both mentioned, both the people are mentioned, then said is changed to told. Next one. Imperative sentence, a request or a command. Teacher said to me, shut the door. Teacher ordered me to shut the door. He said to me, shut the door. He requested me to shut the door. He said to me, you should work hard to pass the exam. He advised me that I should work hard to pass the exam. He said to me not to smoke. He forbade me to smoke. Now see, these are the statements where we see that the reporting verb is put in a different word and not as said or told. So first one, the teacher ordered. Second one, the same thing is there, shut the door, but it is requested. He requested. Third one, we see that there is an advice that is put there. So he advised. It could be he said, but it is better when we write he advised. And the same way, the fourth one, he said to me not to smoke. So you are trying to forbid somebody for doing something wrong. And therefore the word forbid. So in the reporting verb, there is a change according to the reported speech in order to change the sentence, which gives a direct command or makes a request, or if there is a piece of advice, or if someone wants to prevent somebody else from doing something which is not right, then the verb itself has to denote that. In imperative sentence, sometimes there is a confusion whether what was said was a command or a request. Close the door. If it is you want to show that it is an order, then you have to use the word order to show. So, he ordered him to close the door. But if you want to show it is a request or the same word, same phrase that is made, same statement that is made, then you will write, he requested him to close the door. So, imperative sentences are such that if you want to show what is the intention, you have to use that word or that verb that will show what the intention was in the action. Next one, interrogative sentence. I said to her, when do you do your homework? I asked her when she did her homework. We said to him, are you ill? We asked him if he was ill. She says, who is he? She says, who he is. Okay, now see the change. One, that the question form is changed into a statement. Very important in interrogative sentences when we are changing direct speech to indirect speech, the question form will change to the statement form. It doesn't remain a question, so no question mark will remain. Of course, we remove the comma and the inverted commas, and also the reporting verb is changed to most of the times as asked. The reporting verb becomes asked. And there is a change in the position of the verb in the second part of the statement, that is what the speech actually is. So first one, when do you do your homework? When she did her homework. Okay. Then next one, are you ill? If he was ill. Third one is the classic one where we have not used ask, but the way the verb, the position of the verb shifts, we see that it is a question. She says, who he is. But it's a statement, therefore full stop. So the reporting verb said is changed to asked. If the reporting verb is having an interrogative like are, where, were, is, etc., then if is used instead of that. So when we are, if you see in the second statement, we asked him if he was ill. So if the auxiliaries are used, then we do not use that after the reporting verb, but we use if. If the reporting verb has interrogative words like who or any question word, when, how, where, why, when, then neither if is used nor any other word is added. It is a direct statement without the use of if or that. A full stop should be placed at the end of the sentence instead of the mark of interrogation, that is question mark. So this is how interrogative sentence, we see there is a total reform, total transformation of the sentence when the direct speech is an interrogative and it has to be changed.